Hi, this is Paul. I wanted to make a quick video about the Colin Kaepernick slash Michael Vick, back and forth, that happened last week. Michael Vick was on Fox Sports One talking about the Colin Kaepernick situation, basically how he's being blackballed. And Michael Vick said one of the most idiotic things I think a person can say. Basically, he's saying that Colin Kaepernick needs to cut his afro and kind of, comply, Basically, sit down and shut up, basically, is what he's telling him. Be compliant, basically, he's telling him. And maybe you'll get a chance, which is the most idiotic thing he could have said. Okay, but it's not because he has an afro, Michael, that he's being blackballed. Okay, it's because of his protest and that these NFL owners, the cowards that they are colluding. And to keep him out, which is really, really ridiculous. And Michael Vick, you of all people, you who were convicted of a felony, okay, running a dog fighting ring, okay, and you got a second chance. First of all, Colin Kaepernick doesn't need a second chance, okay? He did nothing wrong. All he did was a protest, a perfectly legal protest, okay? This is America where you have the right to protest. And just because a few of these fans that didn't understand it, didn't like it, okay, please, that's not a reason to keep him from being an NFL quarterback when obviously he has the skills to be one. Okay, this is just basically the owners being cowards and hypocrites, okay, and by basically freezing him out and basically in effect blackballing him, okay. And thankfully, Shannon Sharp, the next day on Fox Sports One on his own show, Undisputed. Ethered Michael Vick, basically pointing out what I just pointed out, that Michael Vick, you were convicted of a felony, okay? You served time, okay? Yet you got a second chance to play in the NFL, while Colin Kaepernick, who just did a protest, is being basically blackballed from the NFL, from being a quarterback, from earning a living in the NFL, just for holding a protest, a perfectly legal protest that even veterans backed him up on. Okay, so this, for you to try to tell him to basically shine the owner's shoes, cut your hair and probably put some glasses on and wear a bow tie and be nice to master, and then master will give you a second chance like I got, is beyond ridiculous. But thankfully, Colin Kaepernick let his words, his act, his tweet, let me put it this way, speak for his actions when he put up this tweet about, Stockholder syndrome, which you can see right here. And you know what Stockholm syndrome is, basically where a kidnapper kind of after a period of time begins to empathize with his kidnapper. Okay? And he's basically saying that Michael Vick, because he got that second chance, now he's being like way beyond sympathetic to the owners, which is really ridiculous, consider that like I said, he got that second chance. Okay? And Michael Vick, if you want to talk about hair, wasn't you the guy that was wearing cornrows, wearing your hair in cornrows and stuff? Weren't you that outlaw type quarterback? Okay, the hair has nothing to do with Colin Kaepernick being freezed out. It's the owners colluding against him because of his protest, because they're acting like they don't want to put up with the backlash. They're being cowards, basically. Okay, Colin Kaepernick deserves to be a starting quarterback in the NFL or even on a backup in the NFL. Okay, and that's my opinion. And Michael Vick, please be quiet. Okay, anyway, let me know what you think of this whole back and forth. What do you think of it? Feel free to leave comments down below. And this is Paul saying so long and take care.